With a solar eclipse coming up, my wife got some of these eclipse glasses, but they kind of suck because you can barely see the sun through them and not very sharp. So I tried sunglasses over sunglasses, blocks about 95% of the light, but it's still like looking at a halogen bulb, so much too bright. And the arc welding mask seems just about right, but everybody online says it's unsafe, so let's try something else. So I could project the eclipse through a small hole, and at a few meters away, that'll throw an image, but of course it'll be fuzzy by the size of the hole. It'd be much better to use a lens. And I have a whole assortment of different lenses here, and for my test sun, I'm going to use this LED halogen equivalent, and at 4 meters away, that'll appear just a little bit larger than the sun itself. And I was thinking also to project the image of the sun 4 meters away, that'll give me an image of about this size, which is fairly comfortable for looking at. So if I put my pretend sun right about here, that will be 4 meters from right here. So I can put a lens there to project that 4 meters away. And I have a 4 meter focal length lens, but I'm actually going to need two of those because I also need a 4 meter focal length to make that light appear like it's at infinity. So if I put those two lenses in here, one to make the light at infinity, the other to focus at 4 meters away. So let's move my focus target until a clear image appears. Okay, that's getting clear. Best focus is right about here. And that's at 3 meters from the lenses, which by my calculation should be 4 meters, so I suspect these might not be that accurate. But 2/4 diopter lenses is the same as a 1/2 diopter lens, so I'll use one of those. That's essentially a 2 meter focal length lens. So let's see, where is focus now? Right up against the wall. And that's now 4.6 meters. So my 1/2 diopter lens is not the same as 2/4 diopter lenses. So my 0.25 diopter lenses turn out to be about 0.29 diopters, and the 0.5 diopter lens is actually 0.47. Didn't realize these were that inaccurate. This lens flipper should be 1/2 diopter, so let's try that instead. Okay, best focus with this one is right here, and this is 4 meters there, so about 4.2 meters, so that's my best lens so far. So that's projecting at 4.2 meters. These ones have a focal length of about 3.4 meters, so if I project with one of those, it'll be a bit smaller, but still, it's quite a distance from where my lens is going to be to where the image is going to be. How am I going to get that lens up that high? Now, if instead of using a 1/4 diopter lens, I use a 1 diopter lens and then a diverging lens to spread my image, I should be able to get a bigger image without going 4 meters away. And I still need that 1/4 diopter to make my sun appear like it's at infinity. So with those two lenses, I now get an image at just shy of 1 meter. Again, lenses aren't super accurate. Now if I put my -3 lens at about 20 centimeters away from where the image appears, I should get an in-focus image at about 0.5 meter away. There. And now comparing that with the lens to focus that light straight onto the paper, I get an image this size, whereas if I have the compound lens, this plus this, I get an image that's much bigger, fainter because the light is spread out more. But that's still a lot smaller than the image I had at 4.2 meters, so let's play around with this some more. I'll just move this lens this way a little bit. And now we're out of focus here, and I have to find focus again. Oh, that gets me closer. That's not what I wanted, so now I need to move this lens the other way around and find focus right here. So now with my 1 1/4 diopter here, -3 diopter here, I get an image this size, and this is the size I get just from using a 3/4 diopter lens straight. So my image is about twice the size, and in fact, if I compare to what I had before, it's about the size of the image that I had at 4 meters away, but I'm less than 2 meters away, but the actual focal length of the lens system is 4 meters. So the way this works, the concave lens just kind of spreads the light beams out to make the image bigger, but we can analyze this in terms of focal lengths. So the -3 diopter lens has got a focal length of -1/3 of a meter, and light coming this way spreads out as though it was coming from this point, than minus one third of a meter. And if you look at it from this side, it would appear that the image is right here. I just focused my camera so that it's in focus at one third of a meter. And now if I put the minus three diopter lens in front of it, that makes distance in focus, even though the camera is focused at one third of a meter. And if the light were focused this way on this spot without the lens, with the lens, that makes the focus at infinity. And back to our compound lens example, the light would be focusing at a quarter of a meter from where the lens is, and so if this lens was minus four diopters, it would make those beams parallel, but it's only minus three diopters, so I have essentially one diopter of convergence left, which means it's now focusing at 1 meter from the lens. But this increased focal distance, of course, makes the image bigger, so imagine light going through the middle of the lens that's not deflected. So this beam would end up here, but it ends up out here. So essentially what would have been this size now becomes this size, four times bigger. And if I move this lens to here where the focal plane is, it won't make it smaller at all. And if I move it further away, then it'll project an even bigger image even further away. It's sort of like a zoom lens. Except in a real zoom lens, there's at least three lenses, and those lenses move around in such a way that the whole zoom lens doesn't become super long as you zoom in, for example. And each of those lenses is actually a group of lens elements that correct for various aberrations in the optics to get a clearer image. But looking at what I get with a plus one diopter and minus three at 2 meters, it's just not as crisp as what I can get at 4 meters away with my longer focal length lens. And I think the problem is I'm running into chromatic aberrations with my plus one and minus three diopter lenses, because those are not color correcting lenses that way. And the more the lens deflects the light, the more of a problem this is. So with my one much longer focal length lens, I run into that problem much less. And this is also why early telescopes were so long, because before achromatic lenses were invented, the chromatic aberrations in the lens were a big problem, and the longer you make the focal length of the lenses, the less of a problem it is. But then I realized if I just put my lens and tripod on the deck, I get another meter and a half of height for free. And so I've got a fuzzy image projected down here of the sun, and I have to move closer to get that in focus. So I've got at least a meter worth of height to spare. And there's some flecks on the sun here. It looks like there's some sunspot activity. So I got about 5 meters from my lens to the ground, and at the time of the eclipse, the sun will be much lower, so I should easily be able to get 7 meters. And that means I'll be able to get an even bigger image of the sun by swapping out my quarter diopter lens for an eighth of a diopter lens, which happens to have a 7 meter focal length because it's also a little bit inaccurate. And what's this? You're still watching even though this is one of my optics related videos all the way to the end? Because those videos always do not nearly as well, but I just love the topic, so I keep making them.